Hello and welcome back to the second test flight episode. You see here the SEO XR is still full of these wools and a lot of small carbon parts are added to this jet. And this episode we want to talk about all these things, and we start with the results of the sleds. Yeah, this was quite interesting, and I'm really happy that the results are in reality the same as if we figured them out here on the theoretical board. It is really so. Also in this small RC plane size, that when we fly slow, that the air goes through here, and even if here are some turbulences and the airstream is not that clean, the airstream that comes through here and is accelerated in this nozzle makes a clear airstream on this area, and this holds, this belongs to the airspeed, holds nearly the whole surface of the airfoil, and that works really nice. Yeah, I want to show you this in this clip. Yeah, here you can see how the walls that are behind this nozzle are very smooth in the airstream. And one thing I figured out is that the angle of attack of this sled shouldn't be too steep. Yeah, you know, I have my droop nose here, which can be lowered. Yeah, and normally they have a relative big way of travel. Yeah, they move nearly 45 degrees down. But when I do this with the sleds mounted in front of them, something strange happens. It feels as if the whole jet is pressed down. Yeah, so the aerodynamic is really bad if they are lowered too much. Yeah, this means when this sled goes too much down. Yeah, I hope you can see this. Yeah, when this sled moves too much down, then this effect that the air goes through here seems to be not possible for the airstream, and the lift is really bad. And also the speed lowers, so this makes no sense. So I had to change the way of travel, yeah. And now this droop nose goes really small steps, but it has to go down, yeah. This still really works. And when I figured out the correct way of travel, there is a fantastic, the whole airplane behaves really much better. It flows more stable. It feels as if the jet is bolted into the air. Yeah, it flies like on rails, even on very low speed. Yeah, it feels much more fantastic. So right after the first thing was adjusted, this means this way of travel, the angle of attack from the sled, Yeah, the second thing was the distance between the sled and the wing. I started with a very small distance. When I take a look here, this was about 6 millimeter. Yeah, this distance from the nose of the airfoil to the sled. I moved it at the end 8 millimeter forward. Yeah, this means, so I painted this right here. I moved the sled as much forward as possible by two reasons. I mentioned that this gap should be about 5 to 7 millimeter. Then it's ideal. Then it's the best nozzle for the best effect and for the smoothest airflow. And the second reason is the whole sense of all this is to make this plane fly very slow. And when we want to make a plane fly slow, we have to decrease the wing load. Yeah, and I can't make this lighter, but I can make the wing area bigger even when I make when I move this wing forward, because the new wing area is when we take a look from above is all what we see, and when this is moved forward, yeah, we have more wing area and so less wing load. Yeah, and this was the second thing I tested in flight, how it behaves with this sleds moved much forward, and the behavior was really nice. It was even better than before, and so I let this as the optimum. Yeah, now it is fixed installed, so we have the optimum way of travel, the optimum angles, we have the optimum distance, and the next thing is to optimize the area where we don't have this sled. This is the area right behind the canard. Yeah? The canard makes some turbulence right behind it, and I wanna smoothen this turbulence. Even I saw while the flight tests that this area here starts to become turbulent. Yeah, when the plane slows down, all looks nice. Except here, yeah, and so I figured out what can I do, and my first idea was build a wing fence, yeah, that the airstream is smoothed by this wing fence, yeah, and take a look what happened, and also I built up this small fin, yeah, and the sense of these two is to smoothen the airstream that is behind the canard. Yeah, the canard has a relatively steep angle of attack, about 14 degree. And so when the plane flies slow, here's turbulence, and this turbulence disturbs the lift of this wing area. Yeah. So, and then before we take a look to the flight, the test flight, I want to show you how I built up these two parts. So let's go to the composite workshop and laminate some carbon fiber. Let's go.
So, first part is done and ready installed. It looks super smooth. I really like it. Really, really nice. And now it's time to install the second part. This one. Let's go. The carbon fiber from the wing fences, these 2 plies, 160 gram fiber, is so thin you can easily cut it with a scissor. This is really nice and make no dust. Just for the rough pre-cut, the rest will be grinded down. But it's just possible with very thin carbon plates. So the next fence is nearly finished. Thank you.
So we saw that the jet can fly really, really slow. Yeah, it is flyable till about 40 kilometer per hour, and even at 30, you can fly straight ahead. And also, it feels absolutely comfortable flying that slow. Yeah, much better with this sleds and with these fences and also these turbulator stripes that makes the air flow turbulent, and the turbulent airflow is much more stable than, for instance, a laminar one. Yeah, that's why I bonded these turbulator stripes up here on this nose section. And also, what makes me very happy is that the acrobatic abilities are still absolutely nice, even with these sleds. Also, the backflight abilities. Yeah, when it is flipped over, it flies super normal, super stable, and everything really nice. But you know, where is a lot of positive things, there are also some not negative, but something decreases. Yeah, and that's the maximum speed. Yeah, normally this jet flies horizontal. A maximum speed with full throttle at about 200 kilometer per hour, and now with these sleds it flies about 175. Yeah, so 25 kilometer per hour the top speed decreases, but also the minimum speed decreases at about 15 kilometer per hour. Yeah, and what is super nice that I can perform the Cobra maneuver. You know this, I get my little hand plane. Cobra maneuver is when you get from normal flight, pull full elevator, that the jet turns vertical and also a little more than vertical, about 100 degree, like this, yeah? And then flips slowly again to normal flight. Yeah, and this is now really much more easy to fly with these sleds. Yeah, I did it in the video from about 120 kilometer per hour. You know, this is really fast. Yeah, pull full elevator, and then bring the jet to normal flight. Yeah, and this looks really cool. Makes really much fun. Yeah, and also these post stall maneuver, this means flying behind stall, yeah, where you have about zero airspeed, where you're just flying pushed by the vector nozzles. Yeah, this is much more easy. It feels much more comfortable, and also the transition from post stall to aerodynamic flight, you don't use that much throttle like before. Yeah, that means that that the lift gets on the wing much more easier and doesn't need so much power as if I did it without these slits. So this was a really big leap forward, and it makes me so happy that it was possible to make this jet so much better than it is already. There is just one thing missing, which can be needs a little bit more tuning, and this is still this area behind this canard. Yeah, the canard has a really big angle of attack, this 14 degree, and this is caused that the CG is nearly in front of the wing. Yeah, that the jet flies stable and comfortable at all. So, and this really much forwarded CG must be compensated by lift from the canard, and the lever arm, that means the distance from CG to the CG from the canard, is really small. It's about this 12 centimeter. This is really small, and from this short lever arm, the tendency to go down must be compensated from the canard. So this has to produce lots of lift, and that's why it needs this big angle of attack. and this causes much turbulence behind it. And yeah, to compensate this, my idea was to build these small streaks. We can see it here in front of the jet. Yeah, these small wings, they have a much longer lever arm. So they are just very small, but because of this long lever arm, they has a much better momentum to lift up the nose. And so my idea is, with this small strakes, they have an angle of attack from 10 degrees. I can bring the canards down, yeah? And so when they are more horizontal, they produce less turbulence, and also this area is more clean and have a much nicer airstream, and also can produce more lift, yeah? This I want to check out in the next test flights. So this is here absolutely new. This is the latest progress, yeah? But nevertheless, I'm so happy with this jet, and also that the transition is much more easy from stall to normal flight. This will be absolutely important for the next vertical jet. Yeah, you know, the transition is always the complicated part, and with this LEDs, this flies so nice. Yeah, and this will also make this VTOL jet fly so much more easy, yeah, and also so much more efficiency, yeah. The whole flight time of this jet increases really a lot, because the whole airflow is so much better at low airspeeds and stall maneuvers. And the second thing what I want to improve was the distance, the start distance, and even the landing distance. And for the start distance, it became possible to start in about 2 meters, yeah. And for the landing, these are still a little bit more, 5 to 6 meters. But I improved the brakes so that they work better. And this I will also check out in the next test flights. Yeah, so it is not the end of all improvements, but the whole project get really a big leap, much more forward, and makes me really happy. And I hope you also enjoyed all this, and maybe you can put some of these ideas also to your projects. Yeah. If you have some questions or something else, you can write it down in the comments. Yeah, if you like the video, it would be nice if you let a thumb up. Yeah, and yes, have a nice weekend, a great week, and we see us in the next video. Bye bye.